Children,
good morning, ma'am.
So we can continue what we are discussing in the morning session. Okay, we are discussing problems based on Pythagoras, isn't it? In Pythagoras theorem, we know that what we know, sum of squares of two sides is equal to the square of the hypotenuse. Okay, hypotenuse is the longest side. How will you fix hypotenuse in a triangle? How will you say again?
Sum of squares of shorter sides.
No. So that is a hypotenuse. Okay. Another way, based on angles. Suppose you are given angle. How will you fix hypotenuse?
Opposite to 90 degree.
Yes, it is the side opposite to 90 degree. Okay, side opposite to 90 degree always gives the hypotenuse. Children, please turn on your video. Okay. Write this question. Okay, this is an important one mark question. It's an important one mark question. Look at here. So it is given. ABC is an isosceles triangle. Write the question. ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC is equal to BC. ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC is equal to BC. If AB square is equal to 2AC square. If AB square is equal to 2AC square, prove that ABC is a right triangle. ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC is equal to BC. If AB square is equal to 2AC square, prove that ABC is a right triangle. Adidev, read the question, Adidev.
ABC is an isosceles triangle with AC equal to BC. If AB square is equal to 2AC square, then ABC is equal to.
It's a right triangle. Okay, so listen, what is given? So here it is given. Okay, given triangle ABC is isosceles. What is meant by isosceles? Two sides are equal. Okay, it is an isosceles triangle with AC is equal to BC. And one more condition is given. What is the next point given here? It is given AB square is equal to 2AC square. What do you have to prove? Triangle ABC is right angle. You have to prove this is a right angle triangle. Okay, we have to prove this is a right angled triangle. Okay, so listen, children. So we start with this given condition. It's a simple question. It's a one mark question. So AB square is equal to 2AC square. Okay, 2AC square means what? We can split this. Okay, in the previous question, we splitted rhombus in 4AB square. Means we wrote that as AB square four times. Same way, 2AC square means AC square. We have to write it two times, AC square plus AC square. Okay, 2AC square means AC square is added two times. We are adding it twice. So in the place of 1AC, we can replace it with what is given? Look at AC, we can replace it with BC, isn't it? So AC square plus BC square is AB square. Okay, why we are replacing here? It is given, isn't it? It is given that AC is equal to BC. Now look at here, whether we are getting the condition here, sum of squares of two sides is equal to third side square. Are you getting that condition satisfied?
Yes, ma'am.
Therefore, triangle ABC is a right triangle. Triangle ABC is right triangle. Now listen, children, can you tell me where you will get 90 degree? from this condition, AB square is equal to AC square plus BC square. Can you guess the angle where you will get 90?
B.
B. No. If it is B, look at this.
Ma'am, C.
C. C is the correct. If it is C, it is correct. Okay. Look at here. How to find out which vertex is common? Which vertex is common? Look at the sum of squares of two sides. The C is common, isn't it? So angle C will be 90. So which vertex is common? There only we will get 90 degree. Okay, you can write now down that one also. Okay, sometimes for one mark question, the condition will be asked. Some condition will be given. And you may be asked where you will get 90 degree means. You keep it in mind that common point, common vertex, you will get 90. Angle C is 90, therefore ABC is a right triangle. ABC is a right triangle. Okay, so if it suppose this question is asked for MCQ for this term one means that, okay, what is the condition will be given? Triangle ABC is isosceles with AC square is equal to BC. If AB square is equal to AC square, then triangle ABC is, yes, four option will be given. Right angle, skeleton triangle, equilateral triangle, like that, four options will be given. If you are thorough with the statement, you can write the correct answer easily. Otherwise, you have to solve it. Yes or no? If you understand and learn it, you will be able to recall this concept. In an isosceles triangle, if two sides are equal and AB square is 2AC square, then it is a right angle triangle. So the statements which we are proving will be asked. There is a chance for asking that same statement as MCQs. Okay. Is it okay, children? Now listen.
Yes,
suppose you are given like this. PQ square plus QR square is PR square. Which angle you will get 90? In which angle you will get 90? Surya, PQ square plus QR square is PR square. Surya, PQ square plus QR square is PR square. So where is, which angle, at which vertex you will get 90? Arjun, can you hear the answer?
Q only.
Angle Q is 90. Which vertex is common? Look at there. Okay, or you can draw the figure and you can check. Sum of squares. So PR is the longest one. PR is the longest. So PQ plus QR. So angle Q will be 90 degree. Okay. Suppose it is XY square plus YZ square is equal to XZ square. Where you will get 90 degree, Melvin?
YZ.
Okay. Angle Y will be 90 degree. Angle Y will be 90. Angle Y is 90. Okay. Now write the next one, children. Write the next question. In the given figure, ABD is a triangle, right angled at A, and AC perpendicular to BD. In the given figure, ABD is a right triangle, right angled at A, and AC is perpendicular to D. AC is perpendicular to D. Show that three conditions are given. In the given figure, ABD is a right triangle, right angled at A, and AC perpendicular to BD. AC perpendicular to BD. Show that AB square is equal to BC into BD. Second one, AC square is equal to BC into DC. Then AD square is equal to BD into CD. In the given figure, ABD is a right triangle, right angled at A, and AC is perpendicular to BD. Show that these three conditions are to be proved. Okay. So I'll redraw the figure once again. Okay. I'll redraw the figure. You copied this question? Did you copy? Okay. Okay, children. Okay. So it is given. It is a right angle triangle. ABD is a right angle triangle, right angled at A. Okay, it is given. It is right angled at A. AC is the perpendicular drawn to BD. AC is the perpendicular drawn. Okay, so we want to prove this results. If you look at this figure, what you can see? From this figure, what you can see? If you are given a figure like this, what you can see? Yes, from this figure, what you can see?
Yes, three right angle triangles.
Very good, Vishnupriya. We have three right angle triangles. Then. Yes, is it Vishnu or Rifa? Who answered it now?
Vishnupriya.
Okay. So, what we will get from here? Three right triangles. So you start from the vertex B, isn't it? We know that. Okay. So by using similarity, one theorem we learned. By that theorem, if I start from this one vertex B, triangle BAD, isn't it? We keep the right angle in the middle. Triangle BAD. Will be similar to triangle, yes, similar to BCA. You start from the again the same vertex, keep the right angle in the middle, which is similar to triangle ACD. Is that no? We will get these three triangles are similar. So now you can't. Yes.
Ma'am, we should write like according to any theorem, we know that.
Or we can write, okay, you can mention, okay, we know that. Here you should write that statement. Okay, or if you are writing according to means, you should write the statement there. Or if you are writing like this here, we should write the whole statement. What is the statement? If a perpendicular is drawn from the right angle of a right triangle to the hypotenuse, then the triangles on both the side of the perpendicular are similar to each other and similar to the whole triangle.
Ma'am, now we should write that.
You write it, otherwise you will not be remembering that one. Okay. If it is one more question and all, it is not compulsory, children. If you, okay, we don't know whether it is this triangle chapter, is it for MCQ or theory part. If it is theory part, if you are not giving the reason, marks will be reduced. We have to mention how we are getting this result, how we are getting. So that one should be mentioned. You should explain it in detail if it is a 2-mark question, a 3-mark question and all. If it is MCQ, no need to write this theorem. You can directly present, okay? So now you write the statement so that you can, you'll be learning that statement. What is the statement? Today morning, I think, Meghna, you gave this statement. Is it Meghna or Rosabi? Meghna, give the statement, Meghna. If a perpendicular.
If a perpendicular line is drawn from. A vertex of the right angle, then the triangles
to the hypotenuse from right angle to the hypotenuse
are similar to each other and to the
then the triangles are both the side of the perpendicular. Okay, if you learn it, understanding the meaning can give it easily. Okay, if a perpendicular is drawn from right angle of a right triangle to the hypotenuse, then the triangles on both the side of the perpendicular are similar to each other and similar to the whole triangle. Okay, so by that theorem only we get this condition. Now take the first one. Triangle BAD is similar to triangle B. If two triangles are similar, we can say corresponding sides are. Savio, if two triangles are similar, corresponding sides are.
Equal.
Is it equal? If two triangles are similar, corresponding proportional. So we can say that BA by BC equal to AD by CA equal to BD by BA. Okay. Now we want to prove the result. In the result, we want square AB square, AC square, and AD square is there, isn't it? So we get three ratios. We have three ratios here. So according to the result. According to the result, here we want AB square or AC AD. You have to look into the ratio. Okay, if we take which two ratios, we will get square. Which two ratios you have to consider? Okay, if I take these two ratios, all these three are equal. So I rewrite only those ratios we need according to the result. So I'm writing the first and last ratio. BA by BC is equal to BD by BA. Now you cross multiply these two. When we cross multiply, we will get BA square is equal to BC into BD. So whether we have proved the first result, first one is proved. Whether we have proved the first result, okay. Two triangles are similar, we get all the three sides as proportional. From this three sides, we select only those sides which we need for proving the result. In the result, if you look at the statement we want to prove, we want AB square, BC square, CD square. Here, we will get AB square if we consider these two ratios. So that's why we write these two ratios once again. And we cross multiply. So when we cross multiply, we get BA square is equal to BC into BD. BA square is equal to BC into BD. Okay. So we got the first result. Now you take the next pair of similarity. We can take BCA. Okay, you take the next pair of similarity, which is the next pair of similar triangles. We have three pair there, isn't it? You take the next pair. So initially we took these two, ABD and BCA. Now you take BCA and ACD. Okay, triangle BCA is similar to triangle ACD. Therefore, we get BC by AC is equal to CA by CD is equal to BA by AD. BA by AD. So here, which two ratios we have to consider? Which two ratios you will consider?
First two.
Okay, we consider the first two ratios. We consider the first two ratios only because we want square. Here, if you consider these two, we will get AC square, isn't it? So I'm rewriting the first two ratios once again. So BC by AC is equal to CA by CD. Now cross multiplying, we get AC square is equal to BC into CD. AC square is equal to BC into CD. So which one we have proved? Which Okay, which is the result we have proved now? Is it the second one or third one? AC square is equal to BC into DC. That means, I think the second one is proved. We have proved the second result. Okay. Now look at the next one. So now look at the, take the next condition, next similarity, which is the last criteria left out here, which is the last two triangles left out here. You can take BAD and AC. ACD. Okay. So again, you take the next condition in triangle BAD and triangle ACD. They are similar, isn't it? BAD is similar to triangle ACD. Therefore, we get BA by AC is equal to AD by CD is equal to BD by AD. Here we will consider these two, because last two, because we need square. So AD by CD is equal to BD by AD. So when you cross multiply this, we get AD square is equal to BD into CD. So the third one is proved. Third one is proved. So thus we proved all the results. Hence proved. Hence we have proved. Okay, so from the theorem, we get three triangles are similar. Then we consider each pair separately and we get the required results. We are proving the required results.
Again, scroll down.
Okay, is it okay, children? Rifa, is it okay? Rifa, Pratyush.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Someone is saying something. Is it okay, Aditya?
Yes, ma'am.
Adidev. Ah, okay, Rifa. Aman. Aman Shakir. Okay. Now write the next one. The next one we are going to learn is a very important 5-mark question. Write the question. Very important 5-mark question. Write the question. In an equilateral triangle ABC, D is a point. D is a point on BC. D is a point on BC with BD is equal to 1/3 BC. in an equilateral triangle ABC, D is a point on BC with BD is equal to 1/3 BC. Prove that 9AD² is equal to 7AB². Prove that 9AD² is equal to 7AB². Okay, if you ask your seniors and all, they will say this is a very important question. Okay, we will make you to learn and write this question again and again. It's a very important repeated question.
Ma'am, but in MCQ, you have 5-mark question.
This question will be asked, and you may be asked to select the result. 4 options will be given. 4 options, suppose.
It is 5-mark question, no? But in MCQ.
Okay, they will be giving the options like this. It's a 5-mark question, but what they are saying is all the questions will be asked. We have to practice it. The 4 options will be given. Okay, if you are thorough with the content, okay, it is given from the CBSE. Concept should be made thorough. All the definitions, all the formulas, applications of questions will be given more importance. So 4 options will be given. If you are thorough, we can remember this answer easily. In an equilateral triangle, BD is 1/3 BC. Prove that 9AD² is 7AB². Okay, if we know the statement clearly, okay, if we read it again and again, if you read the textbook, okay, by looking at the glance, you will be able to mark it clearly. Is that no need to write the steps. If we read it and understand that one. Okay, if you read it in the previous day of exam, then we will not be able to do it. We will be marking some other answer. Then you have to do it. You will be spending 1 hour for doing this question. You do it, try this, practice it by doing 2 or 3 times. So automatically you will be able to get the answer easily. Is it okay, Melvin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let us wait. Okay, by this month end, we will get the portions. After that, we will make sure which all the chapters will be there for the first term.
Ma'am, but quadratic equation was during last year.
Quadratic equation, only the solving part only was there. After that, we learnt word problems. We learnt discriminant. Is that no?
When MCQ solving problems also will be there.
Yes, will be asked. Word problems, some simple questions are there, isn't it? Like that will be asked. Finding the discriminant, finding the value of K. If it has equal roots, find K. Like that, that questions will be asked for MCQ. Okay, now listen, children, we are going to write the proof here. Okay, so we are going to write the proof. It is given, it is an equilateral triangle. So, given triangle ABC is equilateral. Triangle ABC is equilateral. What we know about equilateral triangle? All sides are equal. Then what else you have learnt? All sides are equal. Each angle is 60 degrees. What about the altitude? Altitude and median will be the same. Okay, whenever you are given an equilateral triangle, this is the point you have to keep it in your mind. Okay, if it is an equilateral triangle, altitude and median will coincide. Altitude will be same as the median in an equilateral triangle. Okay. How many altitudes will be there for an equilateral triangle? 3 altitudes. We can draw 3 altitudes, but all the 3 altitudes will be of the same length because all the sides are of same measure. Equilateral triangle means all three sides, all the three sides are equal. So all the altitudes will be are of the same length. Okay. So triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. So I'll draw one figure. I'm going to draw the figure. Suppose ABC is the equilateral triangle. Now look at the next question. D is a point on BC with BD is equal to 1/3 BC. Again, the next thing given is BD is equal to 1/3 BC. This is given. So I named this as equation one. This is equation two. What we have to prove? We have to prove 9AD² is equal to 7AB². This is what we have to prove. So in order to prove this, we are going to do one construction. Because in order to use Pythagoras theorem, we need a perpendicular line. Here no perpendicular line is there. So we are going to do the construction. Construction. I'm going to draw AE. Okay, draw AE perpendicular to BC. Draw AE perpendicular to BC. We draw AE perpendicular to BC. So when we draw the perpendicular in an equilateral triangle, it will be same as the median. Is it correct? Is it correct, children? Okay, we draw AE perpendicular to BC. Therefore, BE will be same as EC, which is equivalent to half of BC. BE is equal to EC, which is equal to half of BC. This one, we name it as equation 3. From the construction, we get the third equality. Okay. It is given, it's an equilateral triangle. In an equilateral triangle, all the three sides are equal. AB is equal to BC is equal to AC. Then from the question, in the question it is given, BD is 1/3 BC. We have to prove 9AD² is equal to 7AB². So if we want to use Pythagoras theorem, we need a right angle triangle. So what we do here, we are doing one construction. We draw AE perpendicular to BC. Now, let us mark the point D. Listen, children, where you will mark the point D? Is it on BE or EC? What is given about D? D is a point on BC with BD is 1/3 BC. Where you will locate the point D? Is it to the right of E or to the left of E?
Left.
Very good. It will be left. Why?
It is 1/3.
Very good. Okay, BE is 1/2. 1/2 means it is half. 1/3 means it is smaller than that, isn't it? So D will lie to the left of E. For the exam, figure will not be given. If we take the point B to the right, everything will go wrong. We will not be able to prove the results. Here, the very important point we have to notice, the point B should be on the left. Is it okay? So we take D to the left of E. If we take the point, if we mark the point on the right side, we will not be able to prove the results. Why we are taking here to the left? It is 1/3. 1/3 is less than 1/2. So 1/3 will be to the left of E. Is it okay? Is it okay, children? Okay. So now we are going to use Pythagoras theorem. Okay, now we are going to use the Pythagoras theorem. So you take the first big triangle. I am going to take the triangle ABE. Take the triangle ABE. ABE, angle E is 90°. Angle E is 90°. Therefore by Pythagoras theorem, what we will get? By applying Pythagoras theorem in the triangle ABE, we will get AB² is equal to, hypotenuse square is equal to sum of squares of other two sides, BE square plus AE square. Is it okay? And Mary? In right angle triangle ABE, angle E is 90. So if you use Pythagoras theorem, which is a hypotenuse there, if you take this triangle A, okay, this is the triangle we consider. So in this triangle, angle E is 90. So AB is the hypotenuse. So hypotenuse square is equal to AE square plus BE square. Okay, I name this as equation 4. We name this as equation 4. Now here, in the same triangle, we have one more right triangle. Which is the other right triangle we have here? Is it ADE is another right triangle? Do we have ADE is another right triangle? Okay, so we consider that right angle triangle. In triangle ADE, again same angle. Angle E is 90. In triangle ADE, angle E is 90. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem. Again, by using Pythagoras theorem. Now, which is the hypotenuse? If you consider the triangle ADE, which is the hypotenuse here? Rifa, which is the hypotenuse?
Ma'am, AC.
Is it AC? Which triangle we are considering here? ADE is the triangle. So, which one will be the hypotenuse?
Angle BAB.
AD is the hypotenuse, isn't it? Angle E is 90. So AD square is equal to AE square plus BE square. AD square is equal to AE square plus BE square. Okay, from here, I'm going to find out AE square. Therefore, what is AE square? It is AD square minus BE square. AD square is AE square is AD square minus BE square. Okay, so now substitute this in equation 4. We substitute this in equation 4. When you substitute in equation 4, AB square is equal to, in the place of AE, you can substitute AD square minus BE square plus BE square. AD square minus BE square plus BE square. Up to that, is it okay? Is it okay, children? We substitute this in equation 4. Okay? So that is equivalent to, now look at here, DE. What about this measurement DE? DE, we can write this as BE minus BD. This BE minus BD. Is it correct? Look at the distance BE. DE, how we can write? From the total length BE, you subtract BD. BE is this full length. This is DE. So how will you write DE? This full length BE minus BD. So DE, we can write this as BE minus BD.
Ma'am, that last one, AD minus BE minus BP only.
AD, see, from the side, this is the second triangle. We consider the smaller triangle ADE. From ADE, we get AD square is AE square plus BE square. From here, what is AE square? You take plus BE to other side. So we get AE square is AD square minus BE square. Substitute this in equation 4. In the equation 4, instead of AE, we are substituting that. AB square is equal to, okay? In the place of AE, we can replace it with AD square minus BE square plus BE square. Here it is same. Is it okay? And DE, we are writing as BE minus BD, the whole square, plus BE square. Okay, now listen, children, listen. Now the important substitution. What is BE? BE is it half of BC? Is it half of BC?
Yes, ma'am.
And what about BD? It is given in the question. It is BD is 1/3 BC, the whole square plus again BE, we can write this as BC by 2, the whole square. BE is half of BC. BD, it is given BC by 3. We substitute it from the equation 2 and 3. From the equation 2 and 3. We substitute it from the equation. So that is same as AD into. Now take the LCM. What is the LCM here? 6. So we get 3BC minus 2BC, the whole square, plus BC square by 4. We take the LCM. When you cross multiply here, it is 3BC minus 2BC. What is 3BC minus 2BC? What is 3BC minus 2BC? 1BC, isn't it? So we get AD minus 1BC, that is BC by 6, the whole square, plus BC square by 4. Here we have AB square. That is equal to AD square minus, when we square this, we will get BC square by 36 plus BC square by 4. BC by 6, when we square it, we will get BC square by 36 plus BC square by 4. Now, take the L's, S, yes?
How AD become AD square?
Yes, which one?
How AD become AD square in the, now the last step?
So here it is AD square, from the beginning square is there. AD square, here it is AD square, okay? Here and all it is AD square. I think here in these two steps I missed out that square, okay? So AD square. Okay, in the question it is there AD. Look at here we have AD square. Now, for these two terms, I want to make the denominator same. I'm going to take the LCM. So that means we will multiply by 9. I want to make the denominator as 36. So if we take the denominator as 36, we will get BC square by 36 plus 9BC square by 36. BC square by 36 plus 9BC square by 36. So what is this? 9BC square minus 1BC square. What is 9 minus 1?
8.
8. So we get AD square plus 8BC square by 36. From 9BC square, if we remove 1, we will get 8. 8 and 36. We can cancel this by 4, isn't it? So we get AB square is equal to AD square plus 2BC square by 9. But BC will be same as AB. BC will be same as AB from the first equation. We know in an equilateral triangle, all the sides are equal. In an equilateral triangle, all the sides are equal. So instead of BC, next step, you replace it with, in the place of BC, you replace it with AB. So we get AD square plus 2AB square by 9. Because BC is same as AB. In the result, we want only AB and AD. We don't want BC. In the final result, we want AD and BC. We don't want AB. So we replace this with AB. Now you take all the AB terms to one side. AB square minus 2AB square by 9 equal to AD square. Now you take the LCM. When you take the LCM, 9AB square minus 2AB square by 9. Is equal to AD square. You take the LCM, 9AB square minus 2AB square is 9. So that is, we get 7AB square by 9 is equal to 2AD square. Now this by, okay, it is not 2. 7AB square by 9 is equal to AD square. Now cross multiplying, we get 7AB square is equal to 9 AD square. Hence proved. Hence we have proved the results. Okay. This is a lengthy question. This is a lengthy question. It's a 5-mark question. What do you have to do? Okay. One more time, go through it. After copying this, go through it one more time. Next class in the beginning, once again, we will be learning this. Before that, once again, go through this question and come. Solve it. Each step you solve it. Here we use the properties of equilateral triangle. All the sides are equal and the median will be same as the altitude.
Ma'am, will you scroll up?
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
See, children, in the next class, in the beginning, we'll be discussing this. We'll learn
ma'am,
this.
Ma'am, can you show the last part?
Okay. Do it once again from the beginning. Read the question and try to solve it again. Then only you'll be getting the steps. You have to do it 2 or 3 times. This is one of the lengthy questions in triangle, but at the same time, important question. Okay, children, I think you finished? Finished writing? Yes, children. Okay, children. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.